Hello, I'm Dr. Giriraj Bora and I'm consultant liver transplant and GI surgical sciences at Artemis Hospital, Gurgaon. So today we are going to speak on hepatitis, which basically is infection of the liver, which is mostly caused by viruses, is known as hepatitis. Now, hepatitis can broadly be divided into acute and chronic. So what do you mean by acute? The acute infections caused by viruses are self-limiting and they do not lead to any long-term problems for your liver. The chronic hepatitis, on the other hand, are caused by those viruses who tend to remain in your body for a very long time. Now, first talking about acute hepatitis, I guess most of the people know that there is a virus which is known as hepatitis A and there is a virus which is known as hepatitis E. Now, these two viruses, you acquire them by intake of contaminated food or drinking infected water. So what it does, basically, once you have this kind of an infection which is caused by hepatitis A or E, you have symptoms which are common to any other virus illness of the body. Like after a period of 10 to 15 days, you can experience low-grade fever, loss of appetite, body ache, malaise, and what follows after 4 to 5 days is that you may experience jaundice, which is yellowness of skin and sclera, as well as passes of yellow-colored urine. So what happens at this stage, most of the people consult their doctor and after doing basic blood tests like liver function test and the virus test, you come to know that a particular person is suffering from hepatitis A or hepatitis E virus. Fortunately, most of these infective episodes are self-limited and does not require any specific treatment except bed rest, adequate hydration, and maintaining good nutrition. And nonetheless, in less than 1% cases, especially with type E virus, it may lead to acute liver failure, which can have disastrous consequences. So what we recommend, even if the illness is mild, you have to follow the instructions of your doctor, get yourself tested. And though most of the patient will recover on its own, but still consulting the doctor till the infection is over is an approach which should be adopted by every patient.